In this tutorial, we will see how to update the application running the controller without using CFactory. The first step is create an upgrade package, also called application package. It is a file containing all the application files. Second step, we have to upload it in the controller using the pen drive or copying the file directly in the controller via FTP protocol or using the CPICO as a disk or using the web pages or Terra. Let's have some examples. We can start using the pen drive. So the first step is create the upgrade package using CFactory. As usual, we have to select the configuration we want to save in the file, upload. So in the previous exercises we have selected the files to upload and then uploaded them directly in the controller via Ethernet or via USB. Now we save the application files into the upgrade package file. As option, we can include a new version of the operating system. So this is a file, an AP1 file that you can download from KSAI. So this is the C suite area, operating system files, download the files and select it here. It is possible also to include web pages, and there is an option auto run, but we will see later. So export the file. Now I export in the desktop. But before to export, we can make a small modification in the application in order to have the evidence that we have uploaded, that the system has uploaded the new version. So in CMask we can add a text like version 2.0. Build. Okay, now export. I export in the desktop, so I remember where I save it. Chill version 2.0. Save. Okay, file created. Now we have to copy the file in the upgrade folder. Upgrade folder of the pen drive if I use the pen drive, or the public memory if I use the public memory. So I told that I want to start with the pen drive, so now I'm plugging the pen drive into PC. Okay, the pen drive already has a upgrade. Copy from the desktop to the pen drive, now disconnect. Now I've connected the pen drive and the controller. Next step, I have to enter in the system menu, so allow enter for 2 seconds. Select the upgrade menu. So this is the list of all the application packages, upgrade packages in the pen drive in this case. So select it. This moment there isn't the autorun, so it asks for confirmation. I didn't change this message, but it is possible to change in CFactory. Enter. Upload successful, press enter to restart. And here is the new version 2.0. Now we can try this option, autorun. The autorun option avoid that the final user has to enter in the system menu and select the upgrade menu. Let's try this. In this case, the confirmation is still required. This time I save directly in the pendrive, so I can save a moment. So, export. This is the pendrive, upgrade. Ok, completed, disconnect. Now I'm connecting the pendrive and the controller. After some seconds, here is the system has detected that there is an autorun upgrade package and select it automatically. So you notice that I haven't pressed the alarm enter to enter in the system menu. The system has opened it automatically. So just press enter to confirm the sequence. Okay, here it is. Well, next. Next is autorun without confirmation. Plugging again the pendrive. So without confirmation, what we expect is that I plug the pendrive and it starts automatically to install the application without entering in the system menu and without pressing enter as a confirmation. So save in the pendrive. Plugging the pendrive. 1, 2, 3. Here is. So the upload sequence has started automatically without any action by the end user. Install new application. It also restarts automatically. Before there was the press enter to restart message. This is really a plug and play solution. Imagine this scenario. You have to update the application at the final customer site. So you can create an upgrade package without autorun here, send the file to the customer. The customer has just to copy the file in the pendrive and plug it in the controller. That's it, without any other action. This is very, very powerful. Now we can do the same, but using the internal memory rather than the pendrive. The sequence basically is the same, that is copying the upgrade package in the upgrade folder of the internal memory rather than the one in the pendrive. So now I'm connecting the PC to the CPICO via USB. And here is, so the drive F is the internal memory of the controller. So we have to copy the file here. I have already created the upgrade package before in the desktop. Here is. So just open drive F, that is CPICO, upgrade folder. Copy there. Like before, we have to press alarm enter to enter in the system menu. Volume not mounted. Why? What's wrong with now? The point is that now I have the CPICO connected to the PC. So CPICO has mounted the internal flash memory as a disk. So the operating system is not able to access to it. This is the problem. So the workaround is simple. Disconnect CPICO. Now I have disconnected cable, and here is. So here are the two upgraded packages that are into the controller. Select it. That this was with the confirmation, and so on. Okay. Now we can see via FTP. I can use Total Commander as a FTP client. Connect 10.10.12 is already the right IP. So this is the internal memory of the controller. Enter the upgrade, copy the file there inside. And like before, install this way. The point is, it doesn't matter how to copy the file here in the internal memory. The point is that it is in a folder called upgrade. Next, web pages. So this is the web server, web pages. There is a feature called upgrade. So we have to select the file. Upgrade package and upload. This is an upgrade package with confirmation, so here is the confirmation. Okay, so I expect that here I see it is uploading the new application. Okay. Well, next and last is using Terra, but I have not a Terra account, so I can't show you. You can find information also in the user manual of CPICO. So upload using CFactory. And here is how to update using the USB, using FTP, using the Terra service. So that's all. So in this tutorial we have seen how to update an application using an upgrade package and how to load it using the pen drive, the internal memory, web pages and the Terra. So that's all. Thank you for watching.